I think we should help those countries which are endangered, like Greece or Portugal, for sure. I don't think, though, it is a good idea just to have the taxpayer bear the whole burden. It would have been better to have the banks which hold claims against these countries bear some of the burden too, because we are not bailing out Greece with a Greek rescue package, but the banking systems of France in the first place, and also to some extent of Germany. The bailout for Ireland was a mistake. Ireland needs no help. Ireland has a very high GDP per capita, which is 15% above Germany's. Ireland is not over indebted. Ireland has a very low tax rate. So if they increased, say, the taxes to the German level, then they could afford huge extra debt with the interest on it in the order of 200 billion euros. I think the reason why Ireland took the money is, first of all, that the interest rate is lower, which they get from the European facility. So it's an advantage for them. And second, because the EU wanted Ireland to really use this facility. Thus far, no one has used it, because for Greece we have an extra package. And one wanted to give a signal, say, to calm the markets. But it didn't work. The whole thing backfired. In the long term, I don't think the euro will be weak. The euro is overvalued relative to its purchasing power parity with regard to the dollar. The dollar is strongly undervalued, and it will remain undervalued because the Americans have this huge current account deficit, while the eurozone as such doesn't have a current account deficit. The remedy for all these problems which have occurred now is constraint. Spain has a huge current account deficit. Of course, it's not comparable to that of Greece, but it's with 5% or so, it's a huge number, and it has to get rid of it. How can a country get rid of the current account deficit? Either it becomes cheaper so that its exports are being stimulated, or it becomes poorer so that people can't afford the imports anymore. There is a misperception by arguing Germany is the strongest economy. It is this the biggest economy, because it has most of the people. Yeah, it is the largest in terms of population. But otherwise not. Under the euro, from 1995 until now, Germany's GDP per capita fell from the third rank in Europe to the 10th rank. Germany was really slowing down, and it developed this huge mass unemployment. The perception that the German economy is the winner of the euro and profited from it is totally wrong. It's absurd if you see what has happened over the last 10, 15 years.